Hello, and welcome back to MFTBT. I am Mondef, of course, and today's episode will be a little bit different. I'd like to talk about EU, that is, Industrial Crafts Energy. And I've set up a few demonstration centers here, and they're all fairly similar. We have a power source over here that's empty, a power source over here that's empty, and a generator. And I'll be burning, for the duration of all of our tests here, sticks. The reason I'm using sticks is because these generate 250 EU, which makes them easy to measure. For most of the tests, we'll be using three sticks. In fact, all the tests. We'll just use three sticks for everything. That'll be 750 EU for every test. This first test here works with packets. Now, power gets sent not in a continuous flow of power, like happens in real life, but they get sent through packets. Some of these cables you can see are burning, they've dissolved, they're nowhere to be seen, because the packet size is too big. These MFSUs output a packet of 512 EU. This 512 EU packet, it can be created every tick at the MFSU. Now, different power sources, we'll get to in a minute, can output different sized packets, but they can always output those packets every tick. Now, ultra-low voltage cable, or 10 cable, copper and gold cable cannot handle this size of packet, the 512 EU packet. Now, these machines can. The high voltage cable, I apologize, and the glass fiber cable, these can handle these 512 EU packets without any kind of a problem. Now, here's another interesting thing. We've also got left over 238 EU in the MFSU. Why? Because it doesn't create a 512 EU packet. If it could, if there were 512, if this got more power so that it had 512, it would create another packet and send it down the line, transfer it over to the other side. So let's move on to the next room. Now we've got a bat box, which creates 32 EU packets every tick, an MFE, which creates 128, and the same two setups that we have from the other room. Let's give each of these three sticks. One, two, three. One, two, three. And one, two, three. Now these will burn, and as they burn, they're burning energy into their respective power storage units, which is then transferred across the cable to these MFSUs. Now notice on these, each time there will be some energy left over in this case, the bat box, 14, because it doesn't make 32 EU packet. The MFE, 110, because that doesn't make 128. And the MFSUs, 238 apiece, since those don't create 512 EU packets. And those packets get created at the bat box, sent down the cable, and they land in this MFSU. This one has 713, this one has 630, 508, and 512. If you're fast with math, I'm not this fast, although I have done the math, you'll note that some of the power is missing. The only one that has all of the power from the sticks is the glass fiber cable. This has 512. A full packet from the MFSU made it down here and landed in this MFSU. The rest of these lost a little bit of cable, a little bit of power, 508, 630, and 713. Now, keep in mind, you have to add what's left in this MFSU and what's in those storage units. And when you do, and you do some math, you find out that we've lost quite a bit of power. So why did we lose power? Well, as packets travel down these cables, they lose power from the resistance of the cable. Copper cable, for example, loses 1 EU every 5 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the 32 EU packet that got sent down here now has become a 31 EU packet, which then travels down the line, 1, and makes it to there. Same thing happens with the gold cable, except gold loses 1 EU every 2.5 blocks. So 1, 2.5 loses 1, another half, 1, 2, loses another 1, and then 1 makes it into here. And you see these numbers and you go, lost 1 EU, lost 2 EU, gold must be worse. But it's not. Why not? Well, because this is outputting 128 EU packets down the gold cable. So the gold cable is actually only losing 2 EU for every 128, where for every 128 of the bat box, we're losing 4 EU, since it has to send 4 packets, each losing 1 EU. So the gold cable is actually better. as long as we can send 128 EU packets down it. I'll save you the math on these other ones. Suffice to say, if you send 512 EU packets, it's better to use the high voltage cable, or for pretty much anything, the diamond pipe is the best thing in the world. This is your best friend. This is the best cable. It's expensive, yeah, but it's the best cable. This glass fiber optic cable only loses 1 EU every 40 ticks. 40 ticks, I apologize, every 40 blocks. Which makes it better than copper for low voltage, and it transmits high voltage, so it's pretty much the best cable in the game, given it's expensive, so there's that. But this means that we want to transmit as much as possible a high voltage power, 512, and use high voltage cabling, right? But we have this small problem of transforming, right? There are some machines that take 512 EU packets, but for example, a macerator doesn't. So let's move into the next room. Here I've got a number of setups. These are medium voltage transformers, which turn 512 into 128 packets. This is a low voltage transformer, which turns that 128 packet into a 32 packet, and then into a bat box. Now, for some reason, some people out there are passing around a myth that as you pass through transformers, you have to do special things and have special configurations. Like, you have to have four low voltage transformers connected to your medium voltage transformers, and you have to have four bat boxes around the low voltage transformer. Or no, you don't have to do that. Watch. 1, 2, 3. That burns all three of those. This has some power left in it. We talked about why that happens before, but this sent a 512 EU per tick packet, which made it to the medium voltage transformer, created four 128 EU packets, sent it to the low voltage transformer, which created four for each of those four 32 EU per tick packets, and the bat box got 512 EU. Zero loss. And then people go, well, this only happens when you send it directly into a machine like a macerator. Well, let's test that too. 1, 2, 3. Perfect. We should get our 238 left in the MFSU, and the macerator is partially charged. Well, that doesn't tell us anything. How much power is in the macerator? I don't know. Right? It doesn't have a measurement indicator. So here's another setup. Similar to the first, we should get 512 here at the bat box. And if we plop a macerator next to it, 512 EU, 512 EU, they look the same to me. So long story short, don't worry about transforming your power. Do it when it's necessary and the transformer will do the smart thing. Don't worry about advanced and complicated setups. They just don't matter. And as we move back through here, use glass fiber optic cable when you can. And when you can't afford it, try to transmit your power in as high EU as you can across long distances. Of course, over short distances, it may not matter. For example, the copper over 4 will transmit perfect power. And make sure you don't use the wrong cable, because if you do, it'll just burn out. Anyway, I hope that answered a few of your questions. I'm Mondef, and I'll see you next time.